How'd they get Tommy Hanneford?
They're mad at them.
They're real circus.
Take care of the leopard.
Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Nobody hardly goes to the circus anymore. Wave it, wave it.
Up, 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 up.
I made it.
I can hold the camera.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'm Katie Galloway, and this is Matt Gould and Evan Eames, and we spent 6 weeks living with these cameras and the Royal Hanneford Circus.
You want to cross the wire with me on my shoulders? He'll record you?
That would be cool. Just sit on his shoulders and he'll cross you.
I was excited when we got this assignment. I went down there, and I think all of us did, with some of these romantic notions of what it would be like to run with a circus.
Well, I actually expected more of a carnival atmosphere with a lot of drifters and people hiding from the law. But I found out it was a miniature version of society with big stars at the top and workers at the bottom, and this created a lot of conflict.
I'm willing to work with him.
He won't work with you.
Yeah, it's a hard life in a lot of ways, but it's also a lot of fun and really fascinating. And the Hanneford told us early on that they have no intention of slowing down, and they're going to fight the odds to keep their circus alive.
Hanneford.
I need a clown, a good clown, or two clowns.
Tommy Hanneford owns and runs the Hanneford Circus.
When I come back, you'll be thinking about how much will we owe all the time you're there so you can finish this and that. And you'll say it's going to be 4 cents. That's what I'll give you.
Well, that's between you and he.
He knows everything. He knows exactly how much each little costs. He knows exactly who's working and who's not working.
There's cleaning stuff. Wash them all off. And they're filthy dirty. Go ahead, lift it up on top here.
One little tour around the grounds of Tommy, and everybody kicks into high gear.
Go for the paint back.
All right, come on.
The insurance guy's not around. You don't have to limp now.
You don't have the insurance anyway.
The Hanneford Circus, again, has been in the Hanneford family for over 300 years. But Tommy is the last of the line. There's not another Hanneford to pass it down to.
Tina, come here. I like to see my circus the biggest, the best.
All right, come on over here. Come on over here.
Well, we've been here almost 52 years.
Brand new fly.
Right here.
Charles, you take care of the leopard.
Taboo. Beautiful, isn't he? You know, I don't have no hobbies. I told you, you know, there's no golf. My goal in life is my circus. I'm married to my circus.
We've been working in three different locations. The Hanneford compound, which is her headquarters, the Caroli Ranch, and here, which feels sort of the most gypsy-like and magical and interesting in some ways.
This is your life.
Yeah.
These two little whips right here.
Uh-huh.
About that. Would you go in there with these two little whips?
No, I would not. I don't think I'd go in there under any circumstances.
We're going to run the cats first.
Send them out.
Lance's act is one of the big acts for the Hanneford Circus. It's a wild cat act.
You're up.
And he's one of the stars of the show.
Open the door. Cowboy, open the front door.
No, Lance.
Put the hot shot down. Here, cut up. My grandfather was a lion trainer, trained all kind of animals. Then my uncle was a lion trainer. And when he retired, he gave me his old cats. I've retired some of them and put some more stuff together.
Go on,
sit. to get him to sit there? Hey, man, you don't know how much work that is. Good boy.
I train just about anything. Elephants, horses, camels, llamas, zebras, anything that shows up. Lions, tigers, jaguars.
Hup, set, Kara said. Everybody said, hup, set. All right, on your feet, hup.
Everything looks so easy, but you don't know how many hours I sit here.
At least they all sat up. Conan. Got a whip now. Conan, him it up. Hup, get up. Sit up there.
Once the circus gets into your blood, there's no way of getting it out.
Hup. Come here. All right, let him go. Go ahead, Hup.
I think that's the most amazing thing I've ever seen. I mean, you in there with how many was it total?
Eight.
Huge cats. I mean, I don't know how you do it.
And next year's gonna be 10, two white ones.
Hold on, Tommy's on the other line. Just hold on for a minute.
Stroopy and Tommy Hanneford are husband and wife team. They run the circus, but in the ways it runs them.
Now, leave this for me.
Married Tommy in 1955 and joined into the Hanneford family. And when you marry into a circus family, that means
really
you've got to be jack of all trades.
Hungry son, huh? Well, go get mad at them. That's it. Get mad at them. Yeah, they want to take it away from you.
We feed him in his cage because then he knows that's his home and he always wants to go home because he says this is where his food is at.
You have to accept the fact that there is to every career there is an end, and if you wanna live it to the rest of your life, well then who will guide you when you cannot walk up and down the steps, you know, when you get old? And Tommy does, that's one of his major problems. He does not want to face that he gets older.
They cut this, take these out, set them here, and then the doctor comes in and with it like a screwdriver, I mean a drill, and then the girls put them back in, put the skin around, and that's it.
19 years ago, I started right in that ring there.
Mark Caroli is Tommy's protege. He grew up around Tommy's ranch and has worked around the animals his whole life.
Get over.
And he has incredible control over them.
Come on down, stay.
It's amazing the strength that they have, especially she's a younger elephant, so she's got unbelievable zest compared to the other two. Like the big one, she's older, it's like an older person. You know, she's gonna be a little slower, but this one here is just, come on, Dad, let's play. She's, what she's doing now, she wants to play. See? Steady, what? Steady, and it's like a 23-year-old person, you know? Sit up, Tina, sit. Feet up, sit up, trunk up. All right, what a good elephant. We're gonna do some double, two men jump on a horse at the same time.
Great.
But I gotta put on my ankles after 32 years of this bad.
Like he used to, you know, he talks about how when he was younger, he would just bring the house down with his trick riding. He really thrives on this showman's life.
You know, Mark at this point really, it seems like, doesn't know what he wants to do next and is pretty anxious about it.
Is it the Olympics or what? And that's 40 years old.
Excellent.
I want to retire with grace, you know, I don't want him to go, Jesus Christ, that old bastard's still out there doing that. You know, hey.
I asked him about how it feels to be not having, you know, to not have another Hanneford in line, sort of, after having it in the family for 300 years. And I know that's a tough question.
She was bringing the big money in. Well, we'll go one more week. And she did a thing where she did this with the body over, and she could hear, rip. And that was it.
We went to the hospital, and the doctor says immediately, they checked me in. And I already had this baby. It was a boy. I carried it already for 3 days, dead in my body. And I had a miscarriage. And then ever since we have tried, never had any, nothing to have a son to continue in Tommy's footsteps. I just never been lucky anymore.
Tommy, who's that little, who's this?
That's me and my son. That's my dog that died. A scalpel buried in the back. It's my son. I sent him home from Columbus.
You went to the doctor?
Yeah.
I put him in ice.
You don't want
put him
that.
In the shower. I had a driver drive him back here. I flew down and buried him.
In Frankfurt?
Didn't you see the monument we got on the back?
You can show me, maybe.
See? You haven't seen this?
No.
It's my son.
What is
it? Scopo. He really was a great dog. He really was my son. Oh, well. Show must go on, huh?
Lance trained his first cat when he was just 16 years old. Most everyone we met is following in their family's footsteps, but no one's sure that there is really a future for the next generation.
Hanneford Circus Winter Quarters in Sarasota, Florida.
This is where all the action is back here. Once they in the ring with beautiful costumes on in gold and glitter and shine.
But it still should be like that.
Never lost a date on account of a bad show. Never in my life.
Well, back here is where the real action is.
Well, Stroopy's been in the circus her whole life, and she's been with Tommy for over 40 years.
She was the daring young lady on the flying trapeze, and I was the funniest man on horseback. And I'll never forget, I took her for a cup of coffee up in the front of the building. And on the way back, I got very fresh, and I grabbed her hand. And as I grabbed her hand, it was all calluses. He's just like a man.
Stroopy was a prodigy, a star performer in camps for Nazi youth. She was adopted into the circus world by her mentor and teacher, Trudy Johann. Trudy raised her, trained her, and together they became a famous trapeze act.
Anyway, these are the Louver sisters, before and now. But we've been very successful. I came to this lady when I was a little girl. She made a trapeze artist out of me.
And this here, this is that. This is our beautiful portrait, Mrs. Hanneford and me.
And then I was the bad guy, came and broke it all up.
Now Trudy is an aging mother, an endless scold. She is an ever-present mother-in-law to Tommy Hanneford.
Okay, children, sit down. Listen, you sit on the table. 1, 2, 3. Tommy?
Yes?
Sit down! And don't move anymore! I hit you!
Yep, we're gonna have lunch, that's good.
I love Stroopy. That's it now.
What did you say?
See, because she was hardly 4 years when she comes in my life, you see?
Yeah, ich muss erst die Lebensmittel ausladen.
Yeah, wie lang? Wie lang?
Gerade ein paar Minuten. Gerade ein paar
Minuten. They're never happy. No matter how you make everything nice, but it makes no difference. They're not happy. That Stroopy, you watch them in and out, in and out. Always in and out. Yes, Tommy. Yes, my dear. Yes, I do it. And it goes all day. Then she goes over there in the middle of the night and shake the animals. I mean, she is a slave to her husband. And that's true. That's it's true. And I don't mind to say so.
Can we have a little pepper, Trudy?
Yes, Mama.
Feed, water, take care of them, practice. Go home, bookkeeping, housewife.
I guess it keeps me in shape. It keeps me busy. I don't have enough time to realize that I grow old.
She'd probably like to retire on a spread somewhere with her animals and enjoy her life and take a rest.
Hey. He's the next generation animal trainer.
I spent some time with Lance, and he's, I like Lance. He's, I think he's a complicated
person.
As generations go down the line, you learn not to do the mistakes.
He's got a lot of respect for circus and for specifically his family's tradition in the circus.
My grandfather got chewed up by lions and
really
clawed up and chewed up real bad. They're real playful right now.
Yeah.
They want to chew everything and bite everything and... Hey! Don't bite me. So you learn, you know, as you go down the line, they teach you not to make those mistakes. You know,
right.
How to do it the right way so you don't get hurt.
Don't bite me. No.
They'll bite you if you put your hand in there. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
My little brother knows how to do that.
The what?
This trick.
Go show me your trick.
Go show me your trick.
There's not a circus, I'm sure, but influence is there.
Can you hold him?
Sure.
I can hold the camera.
Okay, you hold the camera. You point it right. You point it right like that. Just like that. Just like that. All right. What do you want? You want to sit in it?
Yeah.
That's where they grow up in the circus, and that's what they're exposed to. Let's see what you can do. It's not any surprise that they continue in the tradition. So where's your trick? Hey, there you go. That's pretty good. That's beautiful.
Hola, saluda.
All right.
The act that you see the children doing out there, we all did. That was the first act that that my dad did and the first act that my uncle did. Mm-hmm. And I did that act too when I was little. The act that Mark Caroli does on his horses,
yeah.
I used to do the same thing.
Cutting across.
But it just got to be too much and I sold him my horses.
Still on the move.
Push! Better, see?
Okay, again.
When he was a kid, he practiced hard. Every day. He never missed a day. He finished breakfast and he had all the horses ready. Let's go, Mama. I said, okay, let's go.
Let's go, girls. On your places. Let's go.
Wilma's 13 and she's training to do Mark's act.
Good. That was much better.
When I go, say go.
Keep
him
going. Bam, bam, bam. I start
late when you say go. You start late. I say go, you go. Go?
Her family stays with Mark during the winter.
You should
call
yourself.
That's
the one thing about the circus. It's great. Everybody's a big family, you know? Whenever we stick together, the kids are close to their parents. I'm getting tired. Oh, up. Like a goddamn football player.
Yeah.
She's using the same push as she did when she was little. Now she's got to work harder. Well, I know just about everybody in the business, and everybody stays in my place are, you know, my friends.
Maybe if, when he does make it, spot it. If you guys want. I gotta go. We gotta go?
Mark was kind enough to let us stay here in this property.
We'll come out here the day, and we'll just get our balance, group our balance together.
Pedro is a famous wire walker, and he's a headliner, one of Tommy's headliners.
Listo?
And Chino is his protege, and it's their first time working together.
I got a good partner.
I'm very lucky to have him. He's, it's like riding a bike, like they say, you know. From the first day, it's been really good, real smooth.
They seem like a great team, like they work really well together, but the circus can press on even the best partnership.
What's probably the most difficult trick that you perform now?
Be probably my partner does the back somersault. That's when you've done the back somersault, you pretty much reach the top of the line.
Thank you. Kind of made my eyes water.
People in the circus often say they love the circus life, and there seems to be a real camaraderie. But life on the road is definitely stressful and can even be dangerous, so I think everyone's really on the edge.
You just hit that vein, that's all.
Yeah, but...
little over a week left before we have to go to Roanoke, and things seem to be really kicking into high gear, because they not only have to be ready for Roanoke, they have to be ready for the whole 10-month season.
The urine from the horses, it'll come down, and the urine just eats the steel up.
Oh, really?
Oh, it just eats it right up. Yeah, it's like acid.
There's a tremendous amount of work to do, getting all the tents ready to go, all the carpeting, all the seats and everything else.
Not only Lance and Mark, but all of the performers have to function as independent contractors, and they have their own overheads.
Nobody has money. Everybody always comes for me for money, and I don't have none.
Whether it's, you know, the cost of the feed or fuel or maintenance of their trucks.
Will you tell them that when they come home to bring 1,000 pounds of red meat with them? And a bag of dog food.
But Lance is taking some tiger into town as a favor to a bank.
We're going into his shopping center where there's a Walgreens. And
yeah, with a live tiger in the back of his truck.
Well, this is our bank here that we borrow money from. We promised them that we'd bring the white tiger up here before we left so they could, everybody could see it. All the employees there at the bank and the president of the bank. It's always good to be in good shape at the bank.
Yes.
I wouldn't stand too close.
Can we pet him? He just looks so furry.
He's not real friendly.
He's though. Not like aggressive, but if he bites you plain, he'll put holes in you. Put it that way.
Nice sharp teeth. Teeth. Yeah.
Patio. And his belly's all wet. That's why you are all wet.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Mr. Raymond.
All right. Yeah. Come here.
First encountered Lance, I thought that he was a lot rougher on his animals. But then after I, you know, saw him in action and spent a lot of time hanging out with him, I realized that he's working with these big cats, you know, and tigers and lions, and that if he isn't completely serious with them and show them who's boss, then he's in big trouble.
One thing I didn't realize is how dangerous the circus can be.
Bro, I think I hit a vein, man.
There's a lot of heavy machinery.
Think I hit a vein?
Yeah, you hit a vein.
What the hell did you do?
What happened?
You have a lot of heavy things moving around and set up and torn down.
It ain't bad. You just hit that vein, that's all.
You know, that potential danger is something that they all are aware of and live with.
Let me go on the other line. Call me back. I need some support here. Hanneford. Okay, he needs the dates we had Lorelei on. And Billy, act on this immediately, will you? The girl's dead. The Lorelei, the trapeze girl. You heard about that?
I didn't hear what happened.
She's practicing for the Super Bowl in a bungee jump, you know, on an elastic. And something happened. She's dead. Woman killed rehearsing stunt. Super Bowl. See it there?
Okay.
Yeah, just said it, but didn't mention the name.
They had been rehearsing their element of the show for 3 days in the dome. A woman hit the floor of the dome behind a speaker around the 50-yard line.
The bungee jumping act has now been dropped from Sunday's halftime show.
And she's the lovely young lady which was hired by us for the season, and we're all going to miss her. And for us, from a business point of view, it is very difficult to find a replacement as good and as great as she was. Beautiful human being, great performer. And God bless her soul.
It makes me want to just practice harder, because this is very dangerous, and a lot of people, I think, they don't really realize the danger that a lot of performers go through.
If anything happens to anybody in the circus business, we know about it right away, and of course, that's on our conscience when we're up there.
You want to cross the wire with me on my shoulders? He'll record you?
That would be cool. Just sit on his shoulders and he'll cross you.
All right.
All right.
It's very important that you just you trust me and then you just do exactly what we say. Just hold on to my head and wrap your legs real good around my back.
Right.
Okay, so you just hold my head like this and then it's like a ride. Try to get Katie.
You're a little bit nervous?
Well, yeah.
You know, sometimes you just get overconfident and you're up there and if you lose confidence one time, you're gone.
We're probably both going to go
and then
straight
just wrap.
Down.
No, we're not. Just wrap real good, you understand?
All right. Woo!
Now, I've already done it close to a decade here, and I just, and I still feel apprehensive, you know?
You're doing good, baby.
Wrap your legs real good.
I got them real tight.
He's very cautious right now.
He said he's going to try standing up next time. Okay, hold on a minute.
Okay.
Okay, keep wrapping your legs. We're not finished yet.
Okay.
Okay, grab the, see if you can climb onto that ladder there.
There you go.
All
okay.
Right, man.
All right.
Woo! Man, I have an issue with heights, too. So.
Do you really?
Everybody get their ass in gear. I'm going to load one more truck. I don't care if it is out of the
fire. Mrs. Hanneford, that's Stroopy Hanneford, asked me, did I want to work? I said, yeah, I'd like to work with the circus. Would I travel? And I said, I'd give it a try. And I guess I've been doing it ever. Should have been up there and had my broom back down there by now. Now you got to help load the truck. Don't try to run. It keeps me honest. Stay out of the streets. I'm getting too old to stay in trouble.
All the way to the Miller. To the Miller, Tom. Clock the Miller, Tom. The Miller.
Before I met Stroop and Tommy yesterday, I just got out of prison in Georgia for the umpteenth time. For the fourth time, and that was too many times. I want to quit sometime. This work get too hard. I'm getting too old. But, you know, you realize you've become part of something. And people care about you, you know, that means a lot.
I know, bro. I want everybody down there on the ground behind it. Everybody.
He always needs change for the boys. Yeah. You know, and if I give him $100 bills, he's liable to hand out $100 bills to the boys, and that's a no-no. If they get too much money, they might get drinking.
Mm-hmm.
And they... celebrating. They can celebrate when we're out on the road. In our business, they come and go. Some of the kids are real loyal. They've been here for many, many years, but they need temporary help. They just come and go. Mm-hmm. Yellow Hanneford.
I mean, be honest with you, when I thought I was getting a job with the circus, man, I was like real stupid about it. I was just like, man, cool, I got a job with the circus. Quit my job. Moved out of the apartment. And I'm like, man, when do I get to start training for the freak show? And they're like, we don't have a freak show. I'm like, what am I going to be doing? She's like, oh, I got a couple things you can do.
Stretch the carpet out the canvas so you get it nice and flat, okay? So you hit every little corner. Make sure these are the two center pieces which are filthy dirty. And Tommy wants it clean, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
And not a fast job, not a rough job, but a good job. And I want every hand on it. And let's go and do it right, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Kicking our ass,
did you cut the metal already?
I got three guys that work for me, and myself is four, and my dad is five. There's five of us here working all the time.
No, you can't hold this on with a clamp. You got to hold it by hand. 15 to 16 hours a day, 10-minute lunch break.
Well, I've been with Lance and them for a little over 12 years myself.
Looking after the cats mostly, or?
Well, taking care of the animals, helping out on the circus.
Mm-hmm. Lance treats Nelson and Cowboy almost as if they were his animals. He, you know, yells at them just the way he yells at his elephants.
Stretch out. Both of you are gonna wash them so we can get it done quick.
Nelson and Cowboy seem to sort of both respect and fear Lance.
I trust that these cats, very little.
Yeah, I mean, they've been around for a long time, and they're part of the landscape there, and, but they have their particular roles. They're not family.
No bread?
No, we were going to get some.
Those guys work really hard, and that they get paid very little, if anything, and they get fed.
You don't have any hot peppers, Delana?
But they get fed, not in the house, but in the back porch. And so there's this sort of feeding time for Cowboy and Nelson, just a, there is for the cats.
If there's any drinking during the daytime up there where
it's
we're
less
going.
Than 24 hours before the team breaks camp and leaves winter quarters behind.
You're gone.
No surprise, not all the performers cope with the stress as well as others.
Well, it's a special day today.
What's going on today?
I'm Roanoke bound. Roanoke, Virginia.
Hey, while they're all here, hey, if there's any drinking during the daytime up there where we're going, you're gonna, I mean, there'll be no second chance or first chance. You're gone.
And no beer cans, nothing in this truck here.
In other words, if there's beer cans are in there, they can confiscate the whole thing.
I know that.
All right. Won't just remember at night, go ahead and have a drink, throw up, do whatever you want. But in the daytime,
no problem.
And I mean it, just test me out. No
problem. The hardest part, believe it or not, is this part right here. Just trying to remember to get everything, tools, you know, all the equipment, all the cleanup tools. It takes so forever until you start loading the truck.
Load up in the house. Load it up. Load up.
Steady. Move up. Move up, steady.
Put up.
All right, carry the two elephants in the back. You got it, Cowboy? The pony's up on the front.
Yeah, sir. Pound.
And the lion's in the middle.
Wake up,
then.
I didn't do anything.
Yeah, you, that's the problem. You don't do nothing. That's the problem.
No, you were in the way of it, lion.
That's the problem. You don't do nothing.
Ready?
Yeah. I'm going to start loading horse in the truck now.
Okay. Can I just hang out and shoot while you're loading?
Oh, yep. Shoot them going in.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, you need a tail wrap.
Get over.
What about it?
Pedro was having all this trouble with his truck.
Your truck's not ready.
Well, I want for them to at least give me a definite answer.
And they kept on not fixing the truck and saying it was going to be more and more.
Yeah, Gene, this is Pedro Carrillo. Yeah, Ken, can you tell me anything on what's going on with the truck?
Take care of yourself.
All right, son. Take care of yourself.
Where last go?
Was she in the circus as well?
My grandma?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. My grandfather was like a big-time lion trainer, and he was a real womanizer, and she left him with six kids. There wasn't much what a single woman could do in the circus. So she got into wrestling. She was Mexico's woman champion wrestler. Bueno, pues, ya voy. Okay? Cuídese mucho, okay? She's getting older and she's not, you know, she's been kind of sick these last couple years. Okay. And if she was, God forbid, if she was to pass away while I was out here, there was no way that I could go back.
No, no. Ahí les echo un telefonazo llegando, okay?
Okay.
Sí, después tu abuelita.
Van a venir ahí a South Carolina, ¿no? Abuelita, ¿ok? Un abrazo.
See you in a bit, bro.
Yeah, run up.
Yeah. About an hour and I'm off.
Okay, I'll be at the Circle K for a little bit. I gotta fuel up.
No, it's my truck. It's they're waiting for a radiator hose.
What's
How soon can you go pick it up?
It's probably going to be about an hour.
They're about to embark on a three-day journey to their first location.
Well, how many trucks do you have pulling out today?
One, two, three. Three in one automobile.
Five to here. Everybody just pulled out, and we're pulling in.
Basically waiting for my truck to be finished, which isn't going to be done until probably about 2.
Yeah, boy, we're getting off at this exit. Can you copy?
road trip, went with Lance, was long and arduous, and we had several breakdowns, the first of which was only 40 miles outside of Tampa. The whole family came out to help out, and we were stuck on the side of the highway for about 6 hours or so.
Everybody that comes to the circus thinks that when they just see the performance, they think that it's all spotlights and good music and glamour and everything. It's really not.
Traveling with the cat act is not any ordinary road trip. They have to stop, feed the animals, water them.
I hate this.
At one rest stop, they had to buy some more hay.
Can you have patience?
As it starts disappearing, just don't give them none until it's all gone.
I don't have really enough.
You got two bales left.
Some rest stop along the way. They got the number of some guy who could sell them some hay.
Everything costs money. We're almost broke. I told them to bring 30 bales. It's a whole pickup truck load of hay, but it might last. It should last us for these 3 days we're in Roanoke.
Good hay.
Where's the elephant?
They're in the back.
They're in the back end.
You don't have no scraps in there for my dog, do you?
They're furry.
Sometimes they are.
Sometimes. Now, you're along with them sometimes? Huh? Said you're along with
this guy.
He's the one that performs them. I'm the main character. I'll go in with them to help him. I've been clawed a couple times. No serious thing. Minor.
50. 70. Boy, it's getting cold, ain't it?
I appreciate it, y'all.
All right, thanks.
Long day.
Yeah.
Evan drove up to Roanoke with Lance, and I had it easier. I had to fly with Tommy and Stroopy.
I lost my twinkle.
When I first got on the plane, I noticed that my seat was directly in between the two of them, and they were both already asleep. And that was pretty much how the whole flight went.
We were all really exhausted when we pulled into Roanoke, Virginia.
How was your flight? Probably exhausted, aren't you?
But all the problems we had on the way up there were just the beginning.
I'm willing to work with him. I told
him. He won't work with him.
Probably exhausted, aren't you?
Made it.
How are you?
Good.
See you again, man.
So,
how are you?
Good.
Is it possible that I could speak to you in private? Do you have some time? It's very, very important.
Unless you want.
No, that has nothing to do with money.
I cut the camera because he said he wanted to have a private conversation with Tommy, and he gave me a look like, you know, please cut the camera. So I did. And I didn't know it was going to be so important. And he walked right up to Tommy and he said that he couldn't work with Chino anymore. He was afraid of him. He was a slugger. And he thought he was dangerous for the act and he wouldn't practice. And Tommy was furious, you know, in his sort of classic way.
Pedro, what's going on?
I really can't talk right now. I'm sorry.
Okay. So what happened?
He said he's a slugger. Fights.
From this, nobody's perfect, okay?
And he walked right in. He called Pacino's agent, and he was like, you know, how can I get rid of this guy? He's not doing the act.
Yeah, you heard about it? I don't know, but Pedro came and said he's scared to work with him. And he's not going to work with him. And now I'm stuck with this guy.
Shh, what's your name?
I'm going to get rid of him. Yeah, well, we should have had it in his contract.
Well, the young man is
right
here.
We should have had an addendum that this guy, who knew that they didn't get along. But see, we're going to have to eat this guy all year. We don't need him.
What is...
I don't understand.
You're looking right at me. You don't know nothing about this, right?
I understand exactly what
you
said.
You know everything that I'm telling you, man. What's that about, you know?
No, but I don't understand what it's about because he's the one that caught an attitude with me.
Oh, he came heavy, that he's scared to work with it. You was going to hit him. I know.
Mr. Hanneford,
I'm stuck with this, sir.
I'm willing to work with him. I told
him. He won't work with you. He just told me, and I said, I've got this all booked for three people. Here, every place, the pyramid,
I understand that completely. But over there, before we left, I was trying to help him. I was like, well, I'll lend you some money. And he was like, no, just get away from me. You're pissing me off. And I was like, why am I pissing you off? I'm trying to help you. Yeah. And then I told him, okay, you don't want me to help you? Well, I'll leave then. I'll see you in Roanoke. And I left. I told him, look, let's put all the rigging in my motorhome.
You were always late. You never came to a practice, always late.
I was the only one always practicing. And if you ever saw, and actually, he's living proof right there. Ain't I always the only one out there practicing?
I did see Chino practicing.
Thank you. I'm the only one always out there practicing.
Well, you know, I believe in opia, but the thing is, he said he's not going to work.
The thing was that he...
You
he
better
was,
go talk to him.
Thank you, sir.
He's out of trouble.
Always. Matt. Are you going with me?
Yeah, what are you going to do?
I'm still doing my act.
Are you going to go
wire? When he goes back in the wire act, then we'll pay him extra. Go finish the show.
All right. Sure. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thanks a lot.
Pedro and Chino are setting up their rig separately. Now, Pedro's doing the act out him, and Chino is doing a sort of a smaller act, which is a low wire act while he's juggling, and they aren't speaking to each other right now. How'd you resolve the Pedro and Miguel?
Oh, well, I haven't yet, but I will.
We had our differences, but I think it was for the best. Maybe it's a learning experience for both of us.
And now they're both doing their act, but I get this. Chino's act is not in the spotlight like Pedro's is, and there seems to be a little bit of tension about that.
It's good, yeah. Whatever. Circus!
So that's the end of our first 2 weeks with the Hannafords. Certainly not boring.
Once you're on top and you want to stay on top, just don't ever put on a bad show.
The Highwire Walkers, Pedro and Chino, are still not working together. Mark Caroli is totally nervous.
We're going to rehearsal now.
And Tommy has to juggle it all and prepare for his next show, a 40-performance run at the Tampa State Fair.
There'll be a cat in there. There'll be a leopard. Will we do an illusion thing?
Helio, I'm not going to continue this.
Now, I'll go to him once in a while and say, look, you guys need to chill out, relax, enjoy your life a little more. They're just too stressed out people.
The Hanneford Circus has been in the family for more than 300 years.
Tommy's alive, and his love is this circus.
But right now, the future really seems uncertain.
Well, the fate of the circus really hinges on Tommy and Stroopy, the owners, and what they decide to do. They're both well past retirement age, but with very different ideas about their futures.
I think when Tommy quits the circus, that'd be the end of the circus right there for them, Royal Hanneford Circus.
I sense the tension at the top between Tommy and Stroopy, and also all the way down the line. The wire walkers still aren't talking to each other.
Is it possible that I can speak to you in private?
I'm willing to work with him. I told
him. He won't work with you.
Despite this, Tommy keeps building the circus bigger and bigger.
Yeah, in fact, he has two units out right now. One is the big top unit in Tampa, Florida, and the other in Roanoke, Virginia.
And welcome to the Roanoke Civic Center this morning. The Shrine Circus is in town.
I want to talk to Tommy Hanneford, the man behind it all. Over 300 years in the family, Tommy?
Yeah, that's what they say. You know, they say I don't even look that old.
Tommy, he's got a lot of the flair of a Vegas showman.
They go all the way around, you come in here on the finish, and we have a torch for you. You see the torch?
And he's also got a lot of the sort of mental strength of a mob boss.
Lance, we're going to put you right there, facing the front. To stay on top, it's not just, you know, every day I'm plugging to stay up there and be bigger and better. You back up this way. Back up this way. Back up this way. The elephant is coming around. Stand by the finale. Stand by the finale. And you know, they say as you get bigger, it gets easier. It's got harder.
Two adults and two children.
In Roanoke, it was like a big event. It was the Shrine Circus. They'd been playing there every year. Tommy does a lot of work with the Shrine Circus, so they call it the Shrine Circus, even though it's actually the Hanneford Circus.
Looks like we're going to have a weather-wise, have a nice weekend.
You got my check ready? It wasn't always like that, but we started off, you know, on the small side, and we grew immensely in the last 5 or 6 years. And now here comes the funniest man on horseback, Tommy Hanneford. But I like this trick. It's a handstand on the horse, pirouette, forward off the horse, forward, whoop. Listen to the applause, it just keeps up. That's what they call stopping the show.
My trapeze act, I was the Indian princess, and I had 6 or 8 girls coming in with me and so forth. I have been following Tommy all my life. I have been doing whatever he does, and I followed him and faithfully backed him up. What do they say? Behind a successful man, there is a strong woman or something like that. I guess I live by that lead.
Here she is. No net now. No safety of the foot. She was very muscular, very strong, and she did it with such ease. That's what made her great.
You want to perform in center ring at this 1997 Shrine Circus.
Tommy and Stroopy. I mean, they're real circus. I mean, their heart and soul, their lives are the circus.
Ladies and gentlemen, the song stylings of Grandma.
The clown Grandma, he has a sort of a different mindset than the rest of these people here. He seems, and he says, you know, even though I've been in the business for 22 years, I still feel like an outsider when you look at people like Caroli and Tommy.
Grandma's gonna show you her personal private parts.
My impersonal.
It's a dying breed, it really is. This kind of lifestyle is so difficult that when you look at Tommy and Stroopy and realize that this is their life, you know they've gone through a lot of hardship, but they must love it.
It can either make you walk out of there feeling like $1 million, or you can walk out of there with your tail between your legs, go back to the dressing room, God, it's terrible. Tommy and my boss, he depends on me to rock that crowd, you know. So I don't want to fail him, was like a dad to me. You know, he was, he took me in to take his part in the show.
Mark is a very complex character because I don't think that he knows what he's doing with the rest of his life, and he's not altogether comfortable with doing this act. And I think he's sort of struggling right now to figure out what he's going to do with the rest of his life.
Time goes on, things get tougher and tougher and tougher.
In what way?
You get older and it's, you know, your body starts going, hey, dude, either give me some more Advil or quit. This has been my 10th anniversary doing the comedy, but I'm still struggling with it. It's the most humiliating feeling when you had them and you lost them.
Mark, very, very good today.
I couldn't get my ass on the horse. I ate too much food.
No, yeah, you it wasn't the horse.
I shoved my mouth full of food right there, and I cannot get my ass on.
It was both of you.
Me? Yeah. No, I couldn't get my ass on.
No one will be turned away. Elephant rides and pony rides are now underway.
So at age 40, Mark Caroli is thinking hard about what the future holds for him.
I don't know. Right now we're back with the other thing. If we do the Macarena, I'll tell you. Macarena, yeah. Whatever.
Now he's going back to perform in Tampa, his hometown. Just the thought of it makes him nervous. We'll see how he does when the pressure's on.
They're not organized the way they're standing in the opening, is what I'm saying.
Tommy's still in Roanoke, but we're here in Tampa, and Stroopy's come to oversee the last-minute details for the Tampa State Fair.
The Tampa Fair is a plum assignment for a circus. It's a great venue that Tommy has been hoping to land for a long time, and this is his first year here.
Yeah, hello, Hanneford.
Yeah, Thomas. What's she doing the criminy? I wish I would have known that. I wish I would have known that we supposed, because now we got to run around and find some better chairs, different chairs. Doggone it, he's coming up every 5 minutes with something else, that man. How am I gonna do all this? Some different chairs. Where am I gonna get some different chairs? Tommy Hanneford. Never satisfied with anything. He thinks about all these things, and he calls us up and comes up with all that, and if we don't have it, well, then we're in trouble. All right, need a job done. How'd your trip?
Sucked.
Why, what else?
Long and lots of problems.
Coming back from Roanoke?
Yep.
And when are you going to, when are you going to pick up Tommy?
I leave pretty soon. It's 2 o'clock now. He arrives 3. I should leave within the next, half an hour.
What happens when Tommy gets here?
What do you anticipate?
I ain't worried about Tommy till payday.
Yeah, that's the only time we want to see Tommy.
End of this date?
End of this date.
Where's the man?
You the man.
Mr. H.
That's who I want to talk to. Come next week. Not next week, but the next week.
Right.
And I kiss the ground he walks on.
I'm going to slow down. I got to get going. 10 million things to be done yet.
I don't know. Right now we're back with the other thing. If we do the Macarena, I'll tell you. Macarena,
yeah,
whatever.
The Macarena goes good, though.
But you know what? Everybody's doing it.
So long.
Bye.
They got bears over there that do a macaroni? That dance?
What did they do?
A dance? The macaroni, rainy? I know they go like that.
It's a lot of love today.
Grandma is a big fan of the Yankees.
Your shoelace is untied, sir. He's walking and tying. That's very tough. That's very difficult. And it's good for you.
George Steinbrenner, who's the owner of the Yankees, sponsors a lot of events at the Tampa Fair. So he's going to go try to meet George and get some autographs from the Yankees.
Play ball! It's George. It's the boss. Mr. Steinbrenner, I'm the transvestite clown.
What'd you say?
I'm the transvestite clown.
Gee.
Would you
deal with me? You're a good act, too, I'll tell you.
Did you see it?
I've seen it twice.
All right. Thank you very much. Congratulations again.
That's one of the best circuses I have seen.
There it is. George Steinbrenner. The bus. He's the bus. Da, da, da.
New York, New York.
Very hard in the business. For some people, they don't stay. Ask me how do you do it? Like some of my town friends that come and visit, come on the road for a couple of weeks or something on their vacation to see what it's like, and they're like, "Mark, there's no way, no way we could do. How do you people do this?"
He's not sure what's going on.
It's only second bath he's had.
Well, I've been doing what I've done all my life. It's not like I can say, "Well, I think I'll just go down here to the, you know, Mr. Joe's machine shop and get a job," because I wouldn't have no idea what I'd do if I didn't do this.
It must be hard for him to just continue to do it year after year.
Dirty. You're a dirty guy.
When he was younger, all the girls would always go crazy, and he really felt like a superstar. And from what we hear from Grandma and from a lot of the other performers, I mean, he really was it.
You know, and I work a lot of these shows year after year, the same town, see the same people. And you know, they come, they say, "Oh, we come every year to see you, Mark." You know, and I'm like, "Oh, wow, that's a pretty big compliment." But yeah, I hope that, you know, I can always do them a good job until I appear the day when they go, "Well, we're getting bored with you. You don't want to see you anymore. We're tired of it."
Seems like he doesn't really know what he's doing or where he's going.
Grandma, go out there and get the response by himself. He don't need an entourage like I gotta have. That's talent. That's incredible. And I would be scared to death to go out there by myself. You know, with nobody around me to help me to, "Here, Mark, come on, do something funny." Oh, shit.
I gotta have a straight man. It's what you do. I gotta always have that great straight man, or I can't just go out there and do that. You know what I mean? And sometimes if the straight man's no good, I'm dead.
I mean, it's just, you don't need the entourage of shit. Look what that act comes in. My God, all those horses and grooms walking them in there, and I'm standing by there going, and then you come out there standing by the thing with your purse, you know, I'm going, "What the f*** am I doing wrong?"
Mark actually lost quite a bit of money in divorce proceedings over the past several years, and he's not feeling as stable financially as he would like.
At the long run, after I pay everybody and get all this equipment on the road, I bet you at the end of the thing, I probably got less money than he's got. Oh, if you knew my overhead.
Tommy! Tommy, how are you?
Are you pleased what you have found?
Yeah,
or
good,
is
yeah.
What our fan is up and running, and any criticism, anything we can change?
No, there is a list should be all this.
Yeah, in the back here. Well, that's no problem if they find a place where...
Okay, give them the pass. He's standing out.
Tommy's been hinting that he's planning to hand down the circus to three people. Dwight and Kay are two of the circus managers, and then Mark is his protege and who he considers to be his son, and he's planning to do that pretty soon.
It's a pretty huge circus at this point, and it's very lucrative, and so Mark, I think, will be excited for several reasons about finding out that he's an heir to this whole empire that Tommy's created.
Oh, there'll be a cat in there. There'll be a leopard. Well, we do a illusion thing, and we do a illusion.
I'm not going to continue this.
Appears, the cat appears in the illusion act, so she will have a pussy cat in there. And for her, you can tell her.
There's no end to it, to my husband.
I guess a couple weeks ago, Tommy said, "Struby, you know, you're going to do the act in the opening. You're going to do the magic act." And she hasn't performed in like a decade or something, and so she's a little nervous, and she's just now practicing for the first time for tomorrow morning's show, so.
Struby, just the illusion, but no leopard. We'll try one more time.
I guess being around in this business, being an old timer, the antique piece of the Hanneford Circus, here I go again. Whenever they need me, I guess, I'm the good old standby. And there has been many things I have done in my career. But that's a new one, to be an illusionist. And especially when you're in my age, you don't feel like being an illusionist, because this whole life of mine seems like like magic.
We're going to rehearsal now.
Everyone, come in. Do we have a mic?
You've got to put it this way, long ways.
Oh, this is right
long,
here?
Yeah, long ways.
Everyone sit down on the ring curb. Sit down on the ring curb.
The tumblers come out. Cavallini's, then you come around here. Around here with the standby with the horse, Mark, over here.
You do a ballet of the seats. Just keep doing that while the overture's on. Circus, then you should get off.
For him, it's like a vacation if he books a date. You know what I mean? It's right here with him. He's like, "Hi, Mark," and he's like a little kid. Mark, I gotta tell you, I got it. Oh, this is great. I got the. Boy, it works 4 years. I got it. At Tampa, when he got to Tampa, oh, jeez, I thought he was gonna do a backflip.
All right, Greg.
I think we should take it from the top, and I think you should get organized. They're not organized the way they're standing in the opening. I'm saying.
All right.
I've walked in the building in the night. Pretty late to check the animal, and he'll be sitting in the seat. Got a little glass of wine, and he's looking around and stuff, making notes. You know what I mean? And that's his peacetime. And then he'll sit and tell you stories. He'll go back 1,000 years. You know, and it's pretty. That's when Tommy's Tommy.
We proudly present the Royal Hanneford Circus. Blackout now.
The next 11 days are going to be tough. 4 shows a day.
15 minutes.
Stroopy's now starring in the Cat Act, and Tommy's got even more up his sleeve for her. We're all worried that she might just break from the pressure.
Check that out while you're here today at the Florida State Fair. What a great thing is going on.
15 minutes! No, we had a meeting. They all have something to do. He's going to work the show.
No, Royce, you're boss props. You're not out here.
I know that.
Mark, Tommy wants you to come over there and get right behind Johnny just the way he is in there.
Where's Sully at?
Mark has said that especially in Tampa, he wants to give it his all because this is his hometown.
I got red boots. You know, I mean, it's like playing football or something, I guess. I'm more stressed out here than I am in Roanoke.
How they fit? They should be very comfortable.
Mm-hmm. Good. When you're playing your hometown, you want to do good, you know. There's gonna be a lot of people coming to show people, a lot of critics and all that. Knockers, we call them.
That's good. See, and I got spray paint. I can spray these red in there. This is mine?
Yeah.
Okay. Spray what? A little nervous.
Not now.
For the animals and for myself and for everybody in the act. Even the grooms are nervous.
So is Droopy gonna do her act this morning?
Yep. Wait till you see the cops from Jesus Christ. Talk about a laugh.
She has to dress up in sort of a sexy outfit and feels like she shouldn't be doing that anymore because she's 65 years old, and she really feels embarrassed by it. Every time she comes up backstage to get ready to go on, she rolls her eyes and says, "Thomas, I can't believe you're doing this to me. Look at me, I'm an old woman and I'm being forced to do this."
Shabu,
ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, on behalf of our circus producer, Tommy Hanneford, the Avatampa Corporation, and your local Isuzu dealers, cordially welcome you to this all-new, one-of-a-kind, in the world today, Circus Big Top. At this point, it is our pleasure to present for your entertainment the Royal Hanneford Circus!
Spotlight.
I've heard more than once from people that came to the show that this is the best show they've ever seen.
Best really?
Circus
best they've ever seen.
They've ever seen.
I love you for that.
I'm not kidding.
Nellie said to me, my daughter Nellie, many times that she said, Mom, she says, I wouldn't like to have a part of the circus whatsoever. I see how hard you work sitting here killing yourself.
Once you're on top and you want to stay on top, just don't ever put on a bad show.
Tommy and Stroopy have an adopted daughter, Nellie, but she wants nothing to do with the Hanneford Circus.
They are my paperwork, no time for anything, she says, no. She says, I never would like to have that circus.
Run! Yes.
Well, would you like to see Grandma do some popcorn tricks?
Signed him to come back. Such a good circus. Yeah, yeah, people love it.
I was over at Tommy and Stroopy's one night, and I asked Tommy how he was feeling because the day was coming up that he would be telling Mark and Kay.
But it is something to talk about after you die, and after everything you worked for all your life, it is kind of a sentiment. Stroopy, maybe you could help me. I want to tell Mark and Kay about, you know, about what we told Dwight.
No, this is too serious to talk tonight about, honestly. No, I think that's not fair. That's not right, okay?
It was just very awkward in the situation where I was shooting and Stroopy suddenly was questioning this major life plan they had.
Did you listen to the lawyer?
Yeah, but don't you think you should leave at least a choice that Nellie...
You're changing it all around now. You should have said that to Kurt. Don't you remember it was supposed to be the three of them? Am I right or wrong?
Yeah, you're definitely right. But I mean, if you totally, you should leave a choice. You should leave a choice open.
She's having the estate.
I know that.
That's all the property and all the stuff that we have, the money, everything. We're just leaving these guys the circus. And you don't have to do nothing. You could sell everything before we even die.
Beautiful. Sell the two things and have the rest of
what am I going to do? No, I don't want that.
You're going to be right there working with the people.
No, I wouldn't want that. No, I wouldn't want that.
Well, then, what do you want?
I want to do it to like Mama did. Right to the fence.
You've got some people to run the tour thing. and not me driving food trucks all over the road. We got to find people to replace me. I'm 65 years of age, too.
Sylvie, we got the replacement. We got Mark and Dwight and Kay.
Yeah, right here to run all the whole tooting, I mean, up front. But still, Mark has his act. He never hardly ever comes for practice, hardly ever does anything. All he gets is just a fantastic salary and be the big shot. I mean, let's face it, when it comes basically to work...
Then what would you suggest, Jimmy?
Not tonight under alcohol. No. I think it's a hell of a wrong time tonight to ask me about all this, pardon me. Camera on. You see this bloody line here on TV? Have you ever worked with a line? Well, I tell you, kid, if you want to work with a tough character, work with a line. It's my line tonight. We're in a serious, no, this is too serious to talk tonight about, honestly, no, I think that's not fair, that's not right, okay?
Now everyone's on the edge. Tommy's made his decision about the future of the circus. He's got his boots on.
We're spreading ourselves thin. Sylvie, before you go, could I have a little lunch?
Stroopy sees her retirement drifting away, and she's angry.
I would just quietly retire, get myself some animals, and live with my best friends I have, and these are animals.
That's just enough that we can clear the store arena, and then Lance is going to deal with the store arena. Okay, right there.
I'm here in Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Get your truck up. Get your truck up.
And the first show today is at 7:30 this evening.
Show the kids how to do it. Come on.
Everything in a circle.
Tommy, you the best goddamn producer. Oh, I'm sorry. Bleep, bleep, producer it is. I didn't say that we got along very well all the time. Make sure that he see this. But he the best producer and the guy that I most respect, and his wife is just like, well, more than my mother to me.
I'm just a little aggravated.
Aggravated?
Yeah.
I was 20 years old when he's fairly new to wire walking, although he's not new to the circus. Pedro comes from a real high wire walker tradition. He's been doing it for a long time, and he's one of the best in the country. Chino was working with Pedro. It was their first time together, and they had developed a sort of a mentor-protege relationship, but Pedro said that he couldn't work with Chino anymore.
Well, it's too bad, because I really thought we would have had a good act. His problem is just that he's got this... this character. There's a lot of people here on the show that already don't know about him. And the bad part for him is, you know, I already let him go with my work. For his children, for his family, for his wife. If he continues like that, who knows what can happen?
When I was gonna start working with him, it was actually something new for me, because, you know, working by myself ain't new to me. But I don't know if I will ever work with him again. I guess that would be like up to him, you know?
You start thinking about Chino and what he's going to do, and I guess this is probably one of the circus dilemmas. Chino's got a wife and a newborn baby, and he's driving around the country in this RV. And, you know, he's starting to get a bad reputation in the business.
You're looking for my hand.
You're looking.
You're over here going. Leave your foot alone.
I think that's one of the more distressing aspects of this circus life, is how close you always are to sort of unemployment, desperate straits.
Chino's wife thought she was coming on the road to take care of their newborn baby, but now the baby's sort of sitting on the sidelines while she and Chino rush to prepare a new act.
This business, the realistic part about it, the bottom line is that it's not the greatest business in the world. I mean, unless you're, it's show business, you know? I mean, I'm not trying to mock it, I'm not trying to put it down, but circus business, it's 1 minute you're up, next minute you're down, and you're basically, you have no benefit.
Even as Tommy's circus has been growing, the circus as an institution is on the decline, and so I think that's hard for these acts.
You're looking at the last of the real circus performers here, so make sure you record it good.
Are we pretty?
Well,
Francis, the show starts here in just about an hour. Everything is in place. The three rings are up. All that's left is an audience to complete the atmosphere. The circus is in town through Thursday. Tonight is WECT night, and that means tickets are only $6.
This man was voted the sexiest man in Guatemala.
Sexiest man in Guatemala. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, the all-new for 1997 Royal Hanneford Circus!
The opening show in Fayetteville did not go well at all. There was a lot of problems with the props being not in the right place at the right time. During Pedro and Tatiana's aerial act, there weren't any mats underneath them, and Batista racing to drag the mats underneath them during the act.
What you see out there is real. People are doing tricks. They're risking their lives. When Lance is in there with the lions and tigers, he's in there with wild beasts, and he is risking his neck.
That potential danger is something that they all are aware of and live with.
It's like a high. It's like a natural high. It's like a, well, let's see if I can go in there and come back out in one piece. I don't like the type of animal that doesn't respond. Like the one tiger that hops on his hind legs. I love that tiger.
All right, folks, are we ready? Yeah!
Whenever I ask him to do something, he's right on the ball, right? Just ready to please you any minute you ask him to do anything, you know?
Sheriff, come here. Hop!
Yeah, hello?
Yeah, it's John. Is he in?
Yeah, John. He's just walking in the house here. Tommy? John Brown on the line.
Here he comes. They want too much money.
Yeah.
And it's like I told you, the only bad thing is you go give them that kind of money and the building finds out next time you go in there, it's going to cost us another $4,000.
Yeah. Tommy was upset to find out that the Fayetteville show went really poorly and the attendance was way down.
You know, it's a terrible loss.
We're spreading ourselves thin. But the only thing, it's not going to be right here. It won't be right.
So North Carolina was a disappointment in terms of ticket sales.
We got too big. We grew too big so fast.
Now, Tommy and Stroopy have to muster their energy for the big talk with Mark and Kay.
I'm scared to go over there.
And Tommy said we can film him while he breaks the news to them. But that's not until tomorrow.
Well, it can't be bad news. He wouldn't let the whole world know if he's firing me.
To end this job. It's just too much. We got too big. We grew too big so fast. We should have three officers or people handling all the things.
It's become evident over the past week that Stroopy is not very happy right now. She is really overworked. She's 65 years old, and she wishes, she has expressed to us a couple times, that she could relax and take the next 10 years or so off and not have to do all of the daily labor that's involved with putting the show on, 11 months out of the year.
She would stop immediately if I wasn't here. No, she couldn't handle it. Sylvie, before you go, could I have a little lunch?
How's your relationship with Stroopy now?
We argue a lot.
Redhead!
Straight a lot. And no reason, you know, we've got it kind of made now, and, for 41 years. Still arguing. We argued for 41 years, we still might as well do it for 50 or 60.
If I would have this whole thing, I would not be able to handle this right. But I've been handling a lot of it, but I would not want to just quietly retire, get myself some animals, and live with my best friends I have, and these are animals.
What about a guy?
Human being, and this jealous stuff of my husband. As older he gets, as crazier he gets about men. Man, I'm married to my husband for 40 years. I put this ring on my finger, and that shall be until death do us part. Okay, this is my answer to this whole thing. Men get old and foolish.
Will you give me my lunch, please?
Yes, darling. You know, you've been caught red-handed in your pajamas.
Well, you started. There was no water this morning.
There was water. There was hot water. It was just not warm enough for you. Okay, you big
storyteller.
I see you. Let me heat this up and then let's eat.
Should I take a bath first?
Today's the day that Tommy is planning on telling Mark and Kay that they will be heirs to the circus.
What do you think I'm lucky about?
I don't know. Probably something to do with, well, you know, he's going to have me sort of run that park show. Maybe he's going to make me like a manager of that park show or something. That's what I figured. Maybe, I guess. I don't know. I'm scared to go over there.
I'm not sure how Mark is going to respond to Tommy telling him that he's heir to the circus. When I asked him before what Tommy would do with the circus after he died, Mark seemed to think that there was no way that he would be one of the heirs, that Tommy would give it to someone else, or that he would, that once Tommy died, the Hanneford Circus would be dead.
You don't have no idea what it is?
I have a sort of an idea.
And he's going to put it on camera, this meeting?
Yeah, he wants to.
Well, it can't be bad news. He wouldn't let the whole world know if he's firing me.
Or we could she get Kay? Kay? Where did she go? Come on in, Mark. Hey, Matt, go get Kay, will you?
These guys don't have to be here, but there's no money, there's nothing. It's just, sit down. All right, a little while back.
This guy's scared the hell out of me.
Just after Christmas.
This is after Stupid Night. This is kind of a hard one, after we pass away. But, you know, we're going to be gone, and well, I mean, we're not going to be here forever.
You? You're going to be
up by... You're going to outlive me.
You know, they're looking at the books, how we're growing and everything. What's going to happen to your circus in the future?
That's why we choose you three guys, because you've been here long enough, and you know the pattern, you know this. To keep things rolling, to keep things going, and
to keep the name.
It's nothing you have to. We just thought that was. Well, you're the three wise men in this group. You've been here long enough, and
I'm dreaming.
And it would not cost you.
What about Nelly though?
Nelly will get assets.
Nelly, we choose Nelly because Nelly says I would not want. This is the first thing needed.
She would get Mark the property. Thing. This is just pertaining to the circus, the route, the trucks, the tents, whatever is left with the circus. What would it mean to us, you know, giving you the thing, I mean, that to our heritage, whatever you call it, then selling it and let's... In other words, if we sold the circus, they'd change the name and that'd be gone. And I'd want to hold up the name. And it's a shame that Nellie did say that, and she said it more than once. She wanted no part of it.
It's really great. I'm going to take a minute. Let's soak in.
They were speechless, huh?
Yeah.
I was pleasantly surprised that Mark right away brought Nellie up. That was, I thought, was rather nice.
The show's actually in a trust fund. So it's not, nobody owns anything. You're just kind of running it for them, keeping the tradition going. That's what I think is going on. Right?
I guess. I'm not.
That's what I don't really understand. I mean, like I said, okay, there's four semis. You take one. one you take, you know what I mean? Oh, how does it go? That's what I don't understand. So that's why I'm like, I mean, I'm grateful that, you know, I can be a part of it, but I don't really understand what, and I guess that'll, I guess he's gonna explain the whole thing later, how it works. Yeah. It's gotta be pretty confusing.
A little bit kind of choked me up. I mean, you know, a little tough situation. They know now, and hopefully the name of the Royal Hanneford Circus will stay here for another 300 years.
So it's the end of week four, and the idea of running away with the circus isn't all it's cracked up to be. Life on the road is really tough.
We got no power.
Who has no power?
I look like a crop duster here.
And life with Tommy and Stroopy is even tougher.
You just keep your mouth shut, Stroopy.
Dr. Murphy, please. Help me.
Sabu has been in really bad shape.
The circus operation seems too big to control, and with Tommy unwilling to give an inch, well, the empire could be on the verge of falling apart.
And he won't listen. He won't listen to the guy that pays him, and I'm shocked.
Hi, I'm Katie Galloway, and this is Evan Eames and Matt Gould. We took these cameras and spent 6 weeks traveling with the Royal Hanneford Circus, and circus owners Tommy and Stroopy had to make a hard decision recently. They didn't have any obvious heir to the circus, so they had to pick three longtime employees to carry it on.
God forbid something happened to him. He's like an army of five men by himself.
But Tommy himself has no intentions of stopping anytime soon.
Oh, we had a meeting. They all have something to do. He's going to work the show.
They've only been on the road for about a month, and they've already had a lot of problems. There's been a lot of fights and a lot of dangerous situations.
Yeah, and like with Sabu, the leopard, Tommy and Stroopy have had him for more than 20 years, and he's kind of the centerpiece of the show. But he's very sick right now, and it looks like he might die, and everyone's hoping that he can pull through it.
Daniel, Florida State Fair.
Is the leopard better?
Well, Sabu hasn't gone to the bathroom in about 10 days, and at first it didn't seem like it was that much of a problem. It's pretty standard for leopards to get constipated periodically, but Sabu has been in really bad shape.
He's just part of our life. He's just like the elephants. Just like if you have a dog around for so many years, it just become part of your life. And that's exactly what Sabu is.
Stroopy's having a horrible time trying to get a vet to come and take care of Sabu. She's called, I've seen her call probably 10 times, and he keeps promising to be here and not showing up or not calling her back. And so she's pretty panicked right now. Thinks that Sabu might die.
Yeah, this is Mrs. Hanneford again from the Hanneford Circus here at the Tampa Fair. Regarding the leopard, I'm still waiting on a call for you. We got a 6 o'clock show, so I will be out of the office here, and I will be trying to call back, or maybe somebody could come out here and I could leave passes at the gate. This is the only time where we should really, if possible, do something for the leopard. I would appreciate if I could get some help from your people.
Come on. Better.
Keeping the animals clean, well-fed, well-taken care of is important. It's a major investment.
So you grew up with these elephants, right?
Yeah. I mean, 20 years of my life. When I was first out with her, she was this big. I could put my hand on her back like that. Just a baby.
Now you can stand up on her head.
Yeah. Aren't you? Yeah. Sometimes a little bit of a cuckoo brain.
Do animal rights activists, show up at a lot of your events?
Yeah, well, they're a pain in the ass, but this is America, you know. No matter what they say, the animal activists and what have you, that the animals live probably three times as long in captivity than in the wilds.
15 minutes, here they are. Look at them, they're already. Circus girls, they're ready way early.
You're in a rush, but tell me a little bit more about what's going on with Sabu.
Well, Sabu, like I said, right now he's at the standstill. We really don't know, I'm just waiting. We have to do something drastic. If it doesn't happen pretty soon, then we have to do something drastic. But I certainly will try everything possible to save him.
Hi, son.
The best solution for this thing is that he does move.
Come on.
Just to leave him lay there is no good. If you're constipated, the answer is exercise. Try to move.
Come on, let's go. Come on.
though Sabu is feeling really horrible, like any other circus performer, he has to go on because his cat act is kind of the focus of the grand opening.
Stop the nonsense.
Let's go. Stand by. Here we go.
Calling for Dr. Murphy. Dr. Murphy, please help me. It looks like the cat is definitely going down, and if you could see your way clear of coming out this evening, if we could maybe sedate him and see that we get some mineral oil into him, I would greatly appreciate if you would call me back, please.
Stroopy is still waiting for the vet to show up, but now she's searching for this tiger trainer who's supposedly here to see the show today. She's hoping he may be able to give her some sort of advice.
He's Joseph Marcan. He's got tigers. He's a very experienced man, doggone it. I've seen him and never doggone occurred to me that I could grab him. He may be my answer what the heck to do. Yeah, he would be. If you see him, put your glass.
The vet is here, and what's going on is Sabu is very sick, and Stroopy's been waiting on the vet for a long time, so we're going to go and try and catch. And there's Stroopy.
I've never met Dr. Murphy. He works with exotic animals, so he's evidently he knows what he's talking about.
18-year-old leopards, I really worry about some of the chronic geriatric problems that people think their cats constipated or obstipated, and in fact the cat is in renal failure or something much more serious.
Okay, now I'm gonna bring him on over. Come on, big guy.
Gosh, I know, that's a little confusing, isn't it? Do you guys have a towel or something? We put him around his eyes. He's fine.
Thanks. Let's get set for an IV.
So what are we doing now? He's getting an IV?
We're just kind of getting him all stable so that we're comfortable. Are you gonna stick with me for a little bit? Why don't you come back over here and hold this leg up? I don't want him to rake across there and pull my, or hook this line and pull my IV out. Now, see if he starts to move on me, wham, I can give him a little something here. Which, the drugs I use, he will move on me.
One of the main drugs that are keeping him down, I can reverse it so he'll wake up. So, he's a sick cat.
Good.
Thank you very much.
I'm thinking about flooding it. I'm trying to get some water back behind it. Associated with that mass. You don't feel me against the side. There you go.
I hope you don't have to do this very often.
Yeah, like I said, the history of him is definitely when he goes to the bathroom, it's like a rock.
Can he pump the... Evan, can you pump the pump? Give
sure.
us a pump.
Tell us when you got two in there, or three.
That's two.
But what they're trying to do is break it up and soften it up and get it out through the water liquid.
Okay, I want to get done. I want to wake this cat up. Okay. And continue to talk to him and let him go ahead and rise up on us. Hey, big guy.
Good
you
boy.
You're very good.
Good baby, good boy. It's all right. Good boy.
He did it.
So I'd suggest you guys probably ought to head on out.
Okay.
We'll have a cat that's
Gentlemen,
going to be
did
talking
you hear
at
that?
Us.
So long.
You know, I think Miss Hanneford has a good eye for her animals. She realized that her male leopard was not doing well. The clinical signs fit really well with what was wrong with the cat.
Oi, good boy. All right. That's a good boy. Come on, try and get up. Come on. That's a good baby. Good boy. Move around.
So Sabu seems like he's going to be okay, huh?
Yeah. Sabu, he is most likely, he's going to be sore. Like everything else, when you go through this, and it's going to be miserable.
The crisis with Sabu the leopard is finally over, but in the circuit, it seems like there's always another headache around the corner.
Push the button, will you?
Tomorrow we'll finish up the run at the Florida State Fair and get ready to move on.
The last show, we have one more show to do.
Given the challenges of transporting this unwieldy bunch, there will be plenty more hurdles to cross.
The other one.
She pushes the one to lock it.
Mark's daughters live with his ex-wife, but when he's performing nearby, they occasionally come and spend the weekend with him.
Push the button, will you?
You shouldn't leave a kid in a vehicle, first of all. That was my fault, but she didn't have her shoes on, and I just went into the barn, and she we came back, and she was in the car, good girl, okay, and now I'm going to get in the door, and the door's locked, and the other door's locked, and I said, Marky.
Marky, listen to me, go like this.
Marky, open the door. Actually, that was the funniest thing ever.
Marky.
I hear what it's saying.
Please push the button.
She wants to do comedy in there, because she really is a comedian, that one. You remember when she was putting her mouth on the glass and blowing? And she just thought that was a hoot. That was a funny bit. Did you get any of that on film?
He locked us out. Say bye. Say bye.
Bye-bye, boy.
So you are Mark's daughter, is that right?
Yeah.
And how long have you been performing?
Maybe since I was two.
Wow. So what do you do in the act now?
Right I do. Oh, right I jump on right horse seat right and stuff.
You think your little sister's going to do it too?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Every time she comes for the weekend, she doesn't want to leave because she has so much fun. It's very exciting, and she gets to perform, be in the spotlight, have this whole circus community around. And then, you know, she goes back to her mom, and her mom has to send her to school and, you know, make her do her homework and clean her room, and none of the fun life of the circus exists. So that's really hard on Mark and on her mom and on her.
Have fun.
She loves this business so much that, you know, she was sick when she had to go back home. She's got to go to school. And when she gets older, if she wants to come with her dad, you know, does her school, and she's welcome to come. You know, and right now I want her to have every opportunity around the circus, because it is a very difficult business. It's very hard.
Little ballerina on horseback, Tara!
I'm constantly impressed with these acts and workers, that the pace is so relentless. It's just show after show after show, 7 days a week, no breaks. Mark and the Caroli Riders, for instance, the minute they're done with one show, they have enough time to maybe, like, grab a quick sandwich.
15 minutes!
Do you have about 10 minutes before the show starts?
About 10 minutes.
Do you have to do anything to get ready?
I gotta put my bow into my hands on, and I'm ready. Other than that, I'm good to go.
The last show, we have one more show to do. Feels great, actually. This is that'll be our 40th show. And then we've got like 10 days off, so it's gonna be very refreshing after this. That's the best part, you know. We work hard for 2 weeks, but then it's nice to know we have a week off.
How has it gone overall in Tampa, do you think?
Good, pretty good. You know, everybody, you know, the four of us are starting to now relax and enjoy what we're doing, you know, instead of worrying about everything. You know, Tommy's having a blast, Mark's having a blast, you know, they're just all
acclaimed by press and public alike to be the finest comedy bareback riding presentation in the show world today. The world famous Caroli Riders!
The time I saw Mark's act, it was a real shock. It's like a throwback to the 20s in a way. There's a lot of bill and a lot of slapstick and a lot of miming. And, you know, he plays a clown, basically. It was really impressive stuff.
We have certain rules here with the circus. Rule number one, no kissing of the girls. In the ring. I said no kissing of the girls in the ring. No kissing of the girls!
Yeah. So you got it! You don't kiss the girls!
I got it!
Good!
Come here, honey. Oh!
Looks like Mark and everyone in the act are having a really good time when they're doing it, but it's actually very hard work, and when the show's over for the day, they're happy to just kick back and relax.
Onward. Here we go. Everyone ride on the midway, right here on the giant wheel. And they start
eating. We're on the big wheel!
I love doing this for the Tans because it's a whole different atmosphere,
yeah.
And it's fun. It's fun. It's work, but it's a lot of fun. We go indoors after this, though, don't we?
It's something about Hamburg, New York.
One unit goes to Hamburg, Pennsylvania, and the other unit is Rome, Georgia.
Yeah, I'm going to Rome.
Right, I was talking to these guys who are at the high diving act over there. When I told them about the tent, they said, oh, some guy fell off there last year and died.
He didn't die.
Who was it?
Me. Covered with dew. It was like giant slide. I come crashing to the ground and woke up 2 days later in the hospital.
And yeah. We're fortunate to have you here with us today, ready to go.
Yeah, I think we're ready to tackle it again. Okay, Tyrone!
The Tampa show is officially over, and they're starting to take down the big top to get ready for a brief stop in winter quarters in Sarasota, Florida. Then they're heading up to the next show in Hamburg, Pennsylvania, which is about a 3-day drive away.
It was a very successful engagement. Needless to say, I could have done without Sabu getting sick, but the veterinarian just was here, just took care of him, says he looks all right.
Don't bite me, I'll bite you back. Boy, I'll take a chunk out of you, too.
Nobody got hurt, none of the horses got hurt. You know, everything was a success. Last night was the biggest show of all. We rocked them last night with the horse act. Tore the house down. Now we're loading up the animals. All the animals are healthy. I didn't know my people got paid today. Everybody's paid. Everybody's happy and feeling. Now we're going to tear it down and move the next town and do it again.
With all the animals packed up, it's off to a supposedly restful few days in Sarasota. But with Tommy around, few things are ever completely peaceful.
He's called the Iceman in the circus world. And how much did you say this was?
$1,000.
If history is any indicator, no road trip is completed without some sort of breakdown, explosion, or catastrophe.
You got no power!
Who has power?
Oh, man, look at that thing smoke. God damn.
Tommy, I'm running to the bank. She's coming with me, Katie.
Hello, okay.
Katie.
Hello.
Stroopy and Tommy are not getting along presently. Among other things, they've been fighting about money because Stroopy manages the finances and feels like Tommy's spending is out of control.
My movements are always fast. Everything I do in my life is fast, fast, fast.
Do you think Tommy has unrealistic,
gets upset that I count the money. Says I'm the owner of the circus, don't you trust me? And when there's a discrepancy, well, I'm responsible for the money. Where is it? Why is it not here?
Come on. They're doing a documentary, I told you. Bring it out. Okay. He's called the Iceman in the circus world. Carries all the ice. We're leaving here momentarily. Stroopy's coming in, and we got to finish this pretty promptly.
And how much did you say this was? $1,000 worth of training. And then we're going to get done before Stroopy gets here.
Yeah.
And she'll clear the deal.
Yes, she will.
And here we go. That's done. Now I can pay my people again.
This is 18 carat. You got a half a carat in the eye and the top. I couldn't even replace the chain for $1,000. If you want it with this chain, figure $2,800.
At times he's known foolishly that he can spend money, and he thinks I come home with a sack full of money, which is not true.
We better wind this up. She's on her way.
She's on her
way.
Look at her.
Yeah, this is for one of those watches. Okay. Which one works?
They both do.
Just tell her I came down to wish her good luck.
Yeah.
She knows better.
Fast women and slow horses, that's the name of the game.
What do you say, Tommy?
I'm waiting on the little Hitler to come back. We're going to start.
Spread all over the two place.
Park your car, and we're going to go.
Tommy and Stroopy fight lately.
What are they fighting about?
I don't know why. They just have arguments. And I make you a nice lunch, okay?
Thank you.
And then I make coffee, and I'm tired.
Trudy's sort of like a mother to Stroopy. She raised her from the time she was 4 years old after Stroopy's father went to war during Nazi Germany.
This here?
She's lived with Tommy and Stroopy for several years.
It's just a name, no number.
Was it a woman or a man?
A man. You think only on woman, you drag sack. Okay. Now, I give you something. I make the sisters a laugh, okay?
So it looks like we'll be, or they'll be pulling out shortly, and Katie's going to be riding with Tommy and Stroopy. We're going to part company, and we will tonight in Hamburg, Pennsylvania.
Trudy and Stroopy have a very close relationship, so it's difficult for them to say goodbye when Stroopy goes on the road, especially now that Trudy's getting on in years.
Here we go. Wiedersehen. Rufen Sie meine Schwester auf. Okay, I do. Okay.
This is no picnic. Where do you see what we got to go through?
What do you mean?
That's just what I say. Where do you find out? I don't know myself. You're going to run into everything here. You wait. Let's go, Stroopy.
Hey, guys, this is it.
So how many trucks do you have pulling out today?
One, two, three. Three in one automobile.
Tell me a little bit about life on the road.
Well, I think if you stick around a little bit longer, I don't have to tell you what life on the road is. You find out.
The Crowley riders just pulled out of their ranch. They're on their way up to Hamburg, Pennsylvania also, although they're driving separately.
You know, going to do the act, as Tommy used to say, he said, that's the fun part. It's packing it up and moving it over the road is the stress. You don't know what you're getting into. You don't know if you're gonna have flat tires, you don't know if you're gonna blow an engine, you don't know if you're gonna, the horse is gonna get sick, it's like the wild, wild west. You just jump on your wagon and ride and hope you make it there.
I'm sitting in the truck waiting for Tommy and Stroopy to get back from breakfast. We're at a truck stop. It's about 7 in the morning. Left Florida yesterday afternoon. But Tommy is not in a good mood. He has been pretty hostile towards Stroopy and everybody else over the CB since we left. And he's keeping it down to a dull roar right now, but Stroopy says that something's gonna blow. He's known for his going nuts on the road, and the tension just seems to keep building. But he's been really unpleasant to Stroopy. She's trying to deal with it as best she can.
Okay, Hanneford. Just
you want
be
me to expose
a gentleman.
You? Do I expose you?
Let's be a gentleman, huh?
Gentleman. Should have been a lady.
Stop being nasty. Are you on the highway? Are you guys coming?
We ain't got no power.
Going out there at the truck stop, you know, the traffic is.
Who has no power?
Oh, man, look at that thing smoke. God damn.
You know what he's done?
Can't even
what?
Get up the ramp. I look like a crop duster here.
Yeah, I bet he's put the gas in with the...
He did put diesel in, I hope, huh?
Did you put diesel in, Russ, or gas? He probably put gasoline in it.
One of the drivers just put gas instead of diesel in the diesel tank, which can do a lot of damage to the engine.
I don't know how the hell you did that, man.
Sorry,
I know, but that's a fucking
Tommy.
Stupid, man. It sure says right on there, diesel.
I know, that's what I thought yeah. It was a diesel
car. Tommy, if you leave that other guy here, we have no room to put him.
All right, there's work to be done here.
Wait, let's take a shirt.
Give that to him, won't you? Give that to the guy?
He's got the mind back in the middle.
All right, whatever you say, boss.
But I don't know where to put him.
Take them all.
Let me
take
them all.
Let him take them all.
No, don't be stuck on that.
You just keep your mouth shut, Stroopy. You're bucking on it like you're the big fucking boss. You fuck things up so much, it's pitiful. You're talking too much. That's what you're doing. You're talking too much.
Things were already tense between Stroopy and Tommy, and now we have this major setback. The mechanic said that draining the gas out of the diesel tank is going to take at least a half a day.
Let it run a little bit first. Let it run till it's clear. When will this be ready?
Another couple hours, at least.
Couple hours?
Yeah, at least.
You don't think it'll damage the motor, huh?
Oh, no.
You sure?
Yeah,
I've heard about Tommy being kind of difficult on the road. How do you deal with that when he goes nuts?
I've been dealing with it for 41 years. And in the 41 years of marriage, I grew accustomed to his ways. It's pretty tough. It's very embarrassing at times. It's over. But then I got so much used to it when I'm not around him, I feel totally lost. They also say, oh, you're a powerful woman. You're the background and the back thing of the business, too. I can handle all this situation back there, but when I'm all alone, I feel lonely. I have no interest in anything. I don't cook for myself. I don't eat hardly. I feel just like a little dog who lost his master, you know.
Well, it's all the way. See the boat right here? It's to the end of the rapids. There ain't nothing left.
Tell me that they start up.
Wants to make sure that he don't get any air bubbles in there. He's filling the other tank up a little. Says if we get air in the system, we're gonna be here for a long time.
Once they're back on the road again, it's smooth sailing until Hamburg.
They're here.
But after the big crowds and cheers of Tampa, Hamburg might be a painful letdown. Tommy's been storming around as it is. Everyone's worried about how he'll deal with the small town.
He won't listen to the guy that pays him, and I'm shocked.
Is this it?
Well, that's what it says.
They're here.
Waited too late.
Yep.
The breakdown set us back about a half a day, so Tommy told Stroopy to drive all night, and then he fell asleep. And when he woke up, he had forgotten, I guess, that he told her, and so he was really angry that she had driven all night, because he figured everyone would be too tired to work.
Hey, that is up all goddamn night. Everybody, all here up, didn't have to do, that was your job. That is up all goddamn night.
He's not straight.
Do you remember telling her to drive all night?
No.
You did?
No. I said go after she told me. We've never, Katie, never done that. Never in my life. Well, we didn't have to.
He's either crazy or he's trying to drive Stroopy completely crazy. He tells her, you're in control. You have to take control of this whole thing. Don't ask me any questions. And then he goes to sleep for 4 hours while she drives, you know, while she drives overnight. He goes, you better go all night, you better go all night. And then he wakes up and he says, why don't you ask Tommy anything? You never ask me nothing. You got people here, there, and it doesn't even make any sense. He just screams.
She really took hold, did everything. I didn't even know where I was going. Wouldn't even tell me or what town or did it all. And do you believe this? That I don't know what went on in White Plains yet.
Tommy's other unit just finished performing in New York, and they sent back the money to Stroopy, but she hasn't told them what's going on yet.
You know the money and everything? Don't know nothing. Absolutely.
But she
don't
wasn't
know.
There.
Don't. Okay, no, I sent it all, everything to her, but the time she paid this, I wanted to, what's left? Nothing.
She certainly had enough to deal with last night without telling him about finances. That she goes, when I tell him about Poughkeepsie, he's gonna freak out because he thinks he's made all this money based on his calculations, but in reality there's nothing left. He spent so much and there's nothing left.
They haven't been out in 2 days. Open the door to the elephants. We'll get this out. And I want to say something now. If there's any yelling or someone calls you son of a bitch or something, you've got my privilege to punch him right in the fucking mouth. There'll be no yelling, no screaming, nothing.
Is this your office?
Yeah, and that's something.
We were inside the field house here at Tommy's makeshift office. He's making all his phone calls here on a payphone because he's not getting cellular phone reception. He just found out that he has all these problems with his other unit in Rome, Georgia.
Hanneford, now they're fist fighting. So I've got to fire Miguel. Did you hear that, Sibby?
Not again.
Pedro and they're fist fighting now.
It's just becoming more and more evident that this empire that Tommy's built is unwieldy. He can't possibly control what's going on everywhere all at once, and yet he has this need to control everything.
Tommy doesn't feel like there's anybody he can trust. His old saying is, if you want it done right, do it yourself.
There's 12 guys here now standing. See, they're all standing around watching. We could be putting this down.
Stress can drive anyone crazy, and I don't think he's a crazy. I mean, sometimes, yes. The man gets so much pressure that he explodes, but that's what keeps him from going crazy. If he held it inside, you'd have to put him in a rubber room somewhere.
No, you're wrong. You're absolutely goddamn wrong. When they're they got 12 guys putting the floor out,
no, I mean,
this is set already, so you start putting the pull-ups up.
I'm not saying that. I mean, yeah, no, you're right. But, I mean, you can't be on all four units at once.
What he needs someone to listen to, and he won't listen. He won't listen to the guy that pays him, and I'm shocked.
Laura!
I'm
going to
take you to the building. Between practicing for their acts and doing the shows, circus kids have to find some time to squeeze in homeschooling.
What are you doing? How can you take one away from three? Three times one is two. Large animals belong outside. Small, tame animals can live inside. Just animals that belong outside. Just write them down. Don't do your why like that. Erase it and do it hanging. A cat does not belong outside.
The whole idea of school seems somehow incompatible with circus life.
We like it here, but we just keep studying in case something happens or in case somehow there's no more circuses.
Like, we get hurt or we can't work anymore in a circus, we're ready to go to college or to keep on going with your school.
It would be a great surprise, I think, if any of these kids didn't continue in the circus, because they don't really go to school. They don't get exposed to anything else.
I think it's even more funner to grow up in the circus than in town. Because in town, you're 8 hours in school, then you got your homework, then you're thinking what career you should do. And here in the circus, you do 2 hours of school, you work, but you don't work 8 hours like in town. You work 2 hours, then you got tons of time off, and you do your school still.
And you practice.
And you already have a career.
Say hi.
Families that have been in the circus for generations and they, you know, raise their kids into the circus, they depend on each new generation to take care of the family.
She's going to be the best of all the Batistas. She loves it. You know, she loves what she's doing. That's why she's going to be good. Is that the first time you did it?
Yeah.
All right. And when you're about 20 years old, I'll give you a contract. This is for you.
Thank you.
Give me a beso. Beso.
Glad you made it, kid. That's
right. You know you got a room when you bring them out.
Welcome to Hamburg, Matt.
Thank you.
Had problems or you're just coming, lady?
Yeah, what a town this is. Jeez, it's Christ.
Oh, isn't it lovely, huh?
Hey.
Here in Hamburg, they're in this old house behind a cemetery. So it's sort of depressing, especially following Tampa and the big fair and the big top that they had there.
Tommy was talking about 20 years ago when they played the big cities and when circus could still compete with big city entertainment, and just, you know, was talking about the reason that they are in small towns like Hamburg or Fayetteville is that they can't anymore. The circus as an institution is on the decline.